No, my story is that I was hitchhiking in
Italy.
Italy in during six between 63 and 66 when I was in England. I used to go to Europe every year. So I must have gone to Italy, and that I wanted to see that particular painting because I was very entranced by that image first. Second, that I was also interested that there is a pregnant Madonna, which is a very unusual phenomenon
Yeah.
in painting. Very, I don't think anybody has
Only, I
painted a
think one
pregnant,
painting is
as
there,
far as I know.
yeah,
I
yeah.
don't know. Art historians can tell us about that. And I was very keen because I was particularly interested in Piero della Francesca. Now that painting is situated in a place called Monterchi. Monterchi is beyond San Sepolcro, where Piero della Francesca had worked. That is his own hometown, where there is a museum which has large number of his painting. So you go to Monterchi, and in Monterchi there is a children's cemetery.
Yeah.
It is the children's cemetery in which there is one particular portion where this particular mural is displayed.
They call it school. Now I think they call it school.
Parapelli
Yeah.
school, I don't know.
Because they
I
told me
remember
that
that there
school
was.
is closed today. But that painting one can see now. Yeah.
One can see it's one of the extraordinary painting.
Borges actually he wrote about Kafka, and I remember his line. I often quote this line that every writer creates his own precursor. He says, in the first line is this, and I think every painter also creates, every artist creates his own precursors. You create, you when you because you are also an art history teacher and expert on art. Quite knowledgeable also. Many painters, they paint very well, but they are not so knowledgeable about art history. And you have often quoted, you have given so many references your painting. I think no other painter is using so many references these days. So how do you think this about creating your precursors?
No, there are two questions. One is about art history and artists. I have found that since 1980s, a new generation of artists that has come up on our art scene, like Atul Lodhia, Jitish Kallat, Reena Kallat, and several others, they are all very articulate. They know their art history as well. Atul Lodhia finds out places in Italy and goes and looks at these works. There are others whom I know. They have also told me. So it is not that now, in those days, perhaps I may be the only one, but now there are many others, who are also, they know their art, they know their art history, they also are articulate, they articulate their own issues, they give interviews. Now that's one thing. The second thing is about precursor. It's an interesting statement, though I do not know what it means, that every artist creates his own precursor.
He says that Kafka, he has created Browning. Browning was not, you were reading Browning from a different angle. But after Kafka, you find it in a new way. So that is why how you create your, suppose you create something out of Lorenzetti or some miniature, Persian miniature. So it is creating your precursor.
I do not know. I'm quite fascinated by the statement, but I don't go by just literal meaning of it. But if you are asking that if I find something somewhere prior to my time, that means
Yeah.
50 years ago, 100 years ago, 300, 500 years ago. So that means going back in history. And you look at him and you find that there is something which attracts you. And you find that this is something useful to you. So you then learn from that. You perhaps even, as I have done, even repaint some of the painting which they had done. That Starnina, Gherardo Starnina was a painter who had painted a particular image of monasteries, a number of monasteries, which is in the Uffizi Museum, and I was fascinated by that painting. So I used the structure of that painting, but I changed rest. I brought many other images into that, but still working within that structure. Like I did these maps, like Mapamundi. So there is already a map made, which was a 13th century map of the world. So I'm using that map, but I'm changing it. I'm removing some part, I'm repainting some part, I'm retaining some part. So in a way, I'm redoing what was done at that point of time.
Yeah.